a little bit to get centered myself. I hear a lot of words that I use in my work that I do. I work with children primarily in schools, teaching them stress management techniques to deal with things like mental health or depression, suicide, and like things like anxiety for school, stress, and things like that. The thing that first struck me was the story with the little boy. So we work with kids in schools. They say really brilliant things all the time. Our very first lesson is around human values. What do you want to see in other people? They say all the best things, right? Happy, fun, communicative, fast, you know, tall, things like that. And as I get with older people, they say the same exact things. So old people, young people want really nice things for each other. The difference though is little kids I see, they don't harbor those feelings as much. They're able to let their emotions go through them, I see. And I see with older kids, like high school age and college kids, they hold on to them to become maybe spoiled and more dark, and things like depression, suicide have come up in schools that we work with. So the only story that I really have that reminds me of this play I mentioned a couple weeks ago to Elise is my dog also died when I was about 29, 30. And typically I'm really communicative and talking to the people, saying hello to everyone. And for some reason this morning, I just didn't want to talk to anybody. So I just walked, glasses on, get my hair cut. And I saw a boy that I normally say hello to because he had a blue sweatshirt on that had a school name on it. And I went to that school before to coach sports. And I did say hello to the kid, and I came back, and that feeling that the author, the actor talked about with the fight or flight response, when you feel yourself like falling into a trap door, I immediately knew that that kid did something bad for himself, right? So he ended up jumping over a bridge that morning. And immediately I knew without knowing, I felt horrible. I had to talk to myself about that, I felt really bad about it. My research showed me that just the simple act of saying hello to someone, making eye contact, and can really help. So it's really simple, but the work that I do, out of all things that we try to do with kids, try to do with teachers, social connection, so the piece about giving the hand fives that we give everyone, that was the most, I think, special thing for me, because kids seek that out on a regular basis from teachers and from adults in the building, right? They can't express themselves how to deal with what's happening in their lives at home. They at least give you little hints like saying hello, eye contact, and even things like a high five or a pound. So for me right now, I'm just thinking about the little things that we can do, the real little brilliant things like saying hello, being a really good participant with the hand puppet. Things like that can really change someone's outlook in their life. So that's all I have to say. I really enjoyed it.